28 years old and I live in Belgium, close to the border with the Netherlands. And the good thing is that I like traveling as well. So in Belgium, I have the advantage of having the ability to drive the car. However, when you go to cities in Belgium also, it is inconvenient because lots of cobblestones, lots of steps and lots of, well, difficult entries into buildings and museums. Because I like, for instance, at Gravesteen in Ghent, which is a very beautiful castle, but it's an old castle, so it's difficult to actually enter. Since 2015, so that's 3 years now.
Oh, so it's 3 years.
Yeah. And well, we work in INEAL also to make it possible for everybody to live independently, which means to have the ability to make your own choices and decisions. So to say, let's say if you decide that tomorrow I want to go to Italy, or I want to go to I don't know, Italy probably is already, you are tired of it, but Sweden,
yes.
You can book a plane ticket and go to Sweden. While if I tomorrow then decide I want to go to Italy because I like it, it's much warmer there, then it is difficult to book the plane ticket because they will say, ah yes, but 48 hours in advance you should have booked. So we try actually in all areas of life to give disabled people also the same flexibility in making the decisions. This goes from traveling, but also goes from where they want to live and where they want to go to school. So for instance, if I want to go and live in Brussels, I should be able to go and live in Brussels where there are accessible apartments and where there is good public transport to get me to and from my house, which is currently not the case. That's why I'm still living in Zolove, which is a smaller town, but at least there I, because it's a small town, can drive my car to every place I want to drive it. Where in Brussels it's much more complicated. We are progressing, but slowly. Let's say yes and no, in a way that yes, because when I was graduating from university, it was difficult to find a job in the open labor market, because I understand for employers it is a bit scary to see, yes, this is a disabled person, what can we expect? What can we do? What will be how effective will this person be in doing the job? And if you have another person which is non-disabled but has the same degree, then they will take the non-disabled person, which is kind of a natural reflex, I think.
Yeah.
So in that sense, yes, also when the employment agencies were helping me, they were doing a great job in assisting me to find employment. However, the problem was that they were still thinking in the box of it's a disabled person, so the disabled person needs to do a job close to home. And I was saying, no, I want to work in the public service, so go to Brussels. And then the employment agency was saying but it's very difficult with the public transport to get to Brussels. And I said, yes, but I have the car, so I can do it. So their way of thinking was still a bit old-fashioned, let's say. Of course, when we had a few conversations, they started to explore other options, which is good. But their initial idea was still to have me do some gardening somewhere, which was not what I wanted to do. So I think there is some work there. So that there are still obstacles.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm very happy with my job at INEAL, but in a way, you can also say that INEAL is a disability organization, so it is open labor market,
mm-hmm.
but it is not working for the local supermarket or the bookkeeping company.
Yeah, so the bar, it's a restaurant,
because,
waiters.
Because INEAL was by itself more open to disability because they are advocating for it. So I think in a way it didn't take so much time to find a job. I think after a little less than a year I had the job, but it is a job in the sector of disability, so that was by nature more open to disability. So before we can really have jobs in the open labor market fully, I think lots needs to be improved in accessibility and in way of thinking. But also, yes, mainly way of thinking, even, that that employers, but also supporting agencies, can think like, okay, it is possible to get a job in all the areas of employment and not only in the specific disability one. I think Tool for All is a great initiative to actually bring the knowledge. Because, as was said also today in the conference, it's not that people don't want to have accessible services, it's that they don't know how. So education is and training is crucial, is a crucial element. But I think what should be added to that as well is interacting with people you want to actually include. Because there is a lot of knowledge with the disabled people. Have a lot of knowledge about accessibility, not about all disabilities, but their particular disability, they have a lot of knowledge from their experience. So if you involve people with different disabilities in creating your touristic services or your shop or your pavement or your city guided tour,
yeah,
then it is the best way to make sure that it is accessible and will then therefore be used. So I think alongside giving the training, it is talking with the target group, talking with the disabled people or any other people you want to include in tourism. Frameworks from, well, top down basically, but that don't really get to the situation of people living in touristic areas, because they don't know that it was the Accessibility Act, and also the people that are living in the towns and the cities, as long as they don't have the knowledge and the will with in the town, if that doesn't exist, it is difficult to implement. So therefore I think that having this local commitment and local communication is also a key aspect.
Thank you very much.